each squadron had so many airplanes. Once you build up enough seniority to have your own airplane, then you got to choose a name for it.
You had to live long enough to some of them to go home or lose somebody or something to have a, where you got a, had a plane assigned as your primary plane. Didn't mean you flew it every time, but if it was available to fly, you flew it. If it wasn't, you flew some other plane that was available, but most of the time you flew your own airplane.
After I got my own plane, I named it after my high school sweetheart, my girlfriend at the time, Doris Jean.
While I was instructing in June of 44, I married Charlotte Ezell. Charlotte's Chariot was the name of it. And I was in another fight with two of those Focke-Wulf 190s, and I missed the first one, and he broke off, and that second guy hit me with a 20-millimeter. When I got hit in the wing, my landing gear folded up, and it damaged it so much that they just scrapped that airplane and gave me a new one, and that was Charlotte's Chariot too.
I had no romantic interests when I went overseas, so my sister had just had a baby girl, her first one, and she named that baby girl Sandy, and that's what I named my plane.
I was in the 355th Squadron. I was a crew chief. I had one plane that I took care of. Peg of my heart was Colonel Bickles, but I would say Uncle George was my pilot. Almost all the pilots would call him Uncle George. He was the squadron commander at the beginning before he became the group commander. And that was his plane when we first got to Europe. And of course, Peg of My Heart was sort of a favorite to me because at that time it was a popular song. Afterwards, he changed the name of his plane. He changed it to Flagship Nancy Ann. He met a nurse that was in England, and they got married. And so he named his new ship Flagship Nancy Ann. And he left and went to become the group commander. I had a new pilot, Major Talbot, and he named the ship Too Bad.
The Germans were the enemy, and there's a war going on, and we have to beat them any way we can. In my case, I was a pilot, and my weapon was an airplane.
And what was it called again, please?
Achtung. I named it Achtung because every time we were at different air bases, they were previously German airfields. The Germans were using them. So they had Achtung all over the place, and I would say, what the hell is that? Achtung, Achtung. Achtung this, Achtung that. And I asked her, what does Achtung mean? Oh, it means attention. That was in my mind. And then when I got my airplane, for some reason or other, I told the crew chief, hey, put Achtung on there. They put anything they wanted on there. I'm only sorry I was afraid to put a skull and bone. Because if I was shot down and the Germans would see that, they'd jump on me. But Achtung did pretty good. There's my plane, yeah.
Finally got my own airplane towards the end of the war. And it was a P-51.
Yeah, the Bonnie M. That was my own airplane. A girlfriend that I had back in Los Angeles.
I flew most of the war as we spec, my youngest sister. We always called her we spec, so I named my airplane that. After we got on A2 right after the Normandy invasion, my airplane was so old and beat up that they brought me a brand new airplane in, and the crew chief asked if he could name it. So I, okay. You name it, and the next morning when I come back, it already been painted. Grim Reaper was on it, and he had it all decorated. And I didn't object, that was fine. And as it turned out, the most memorable mission I actually run into was flown about 3 days later on the Normandy beachhead. That's where Grim Reaper arrived.
Yes, that's my original airplane. I flew most of my missions in it. You can see it had that old type canopy on it. Everybody was naming their airplanes, and I thought about Leap and Lena because my sister's name was Lena. And I figured, well, somebody had that. And then I thought about Light of My Life because my girlfriend was named Mary Light. And then I said, well, how about something that's worthy of the war? Maybe it was smart alecky. I figured rigor mortis. Said that's the way I'm going to make those people.
Originally, when I was assigned P-39s, I called it by my secret name for my wife, which was Little Pigeon. I had never had a problem with Little Pigeon, but other people flew it too, and somebody else got in it and crashed. So I had to get a new airplane, and I named it Little Pigeon again, and I'll be darned if somebody else didn't fly it and crash. So I eventually was thinking that's not a good name. I was trying to decide on one when I was coming back with somebody that must have outranked me, because we were flying mutual support after being separated from the group. And he said, you stay here and I'm going to get up above you in the sun and maybe we can draw some action. And I said, what do you think I am, live bait? And he said, yeah. So when I got back, I went to my crew chief and said, I want to call this airplane Live Bait. And I had about six or eight of them. It turned out to be a very, very lucky name. It got me through the war.
The plane I got was named Live Bait. It belonged to Captain Gross. And he went home, and I inherited the plane. This plane that Gross had was a new D model. It was the Alita, the 51, the best of the lot, you know. And so it had Live Bait on it. I didn't want that, and so I asked Smitty about it, and he said, what do you want put on there? And I said, well, I got a girlfriend back home who's in the Navy nurse, and I said, her name is Babishook, but they call her Babs, and she's got the rank of an ensign. So I said, let's name it Ensign Babs. So he said, okay, and so he got the painter over there, and they took the metal side off the plane and took it into paint shop and came out with Ensign Babs. And at the same time, he took Gross's name off the canopy and put my name on, Lieutenant R.J. Raymer.
My dad flew a P-51 Mustang in World War II, flew out of Boxhead in England. The last thing he did, they were strafing a German airfield in France. And he flew down firing at a hangar and didn't come up. I found my dad's picture in this book and came across the picture of his airplane with my name on it. I was born November 16th, so he didn't get home to see me because he was killed on April 5th, the following April 5th.
One of the pilots in the 353rd, Jim Burke, he was from the same hometown as I was, from Ogden, Utah. This is Jim Burke here. I think you've seen pictures of his plane, Easy Rocking Mama. I always thought Dick Turner was, you know, one of my favorite pilots. He was our CO for a while, and he really appreciated the enlisted people. He always stops and talks to us, and I painted all his planes, and he had about four planes, and I painted the short view Sally on them. And I got to know him as well as any other pilot.
I inherited
Bob Stevens' plane. He had about 9 or 12 victories. It says killer exclamation mark on it. That was a good airplane. I flew 30-some missions on it. And I wasn't too happy about flying that plane because I see if I ever got shot down and or I have to make an emergency landing in German or French field and I got a killer on it, that's not a good name to be jumping out of an airplane because I don't think you're going to be able to jump out of it too far because someone's going to kill you too.
That is Jim Howard's AJA Dinghao. And this is the plane that was put out right after the war.
I was really happy to see that they used Jim Howard's plane because 354th never got too much credit for what they did. And some of these model companies, they don't do our planes. They just do 8th Air Force stuff. So I was happy to see this. The most famous one of our planes is Ding Ho. Of course, Howard came from the Flying Tigers, and Ding Ho is a Chinese name. It means very good, because Ho in Chinese is good. He had that name all along. When he came in, he had that painted on his plane. There's only two of us in that squadron that did painting of the airplanes' names, and I painted Jim Howard's plane. This is my lettering here. Was my painting, the Ding Hao. We put a lot of victory markings on the planes. I did that for Jim Howard's plane. I had a picture taken of me painting the swastikas on the plane. Yeah, you realize he's got Rising Sun victory symbols on here too, because he had Japanese planes that he shot down.